What's up, gamers? DreamcastGuy here, and this has got to be one of the most insane pieces of news of all freaking time. Sony has just removed freaking Cyberpunk from the PlayStation Store. This is not a joke. This isn't an exaggeration. This isn't a rumor. It has just been officially confirmed mere minutes ago by a statement from Sony. This is nuts. Now, I want to read their statement. I want to kind of just try and digest this, but right away, I am freaking out. I have never, in all my years of gaming, I've played a lot of stuff. Obviously, I have literally 1,000 games behind me. I've never freaking seen a freaking console maker basically say, you can't sell your game. And let's face it, it's because this is just such a broken mess. I bet that Sony was afraid of a lawsuit. Now, let's read the official thing here. Sony removes Cyberpunk 2077 from PS Store will offer refunds to PlayStation players who already bought it. City Project Red has previously promised refunds to players, but they were being previously difficult to get. So basically, they're doing this to completely cover themselves. Straight up, this is something you may not know. If you're selling a game that's completely broken, like, people can get in trouble for selling a game that is straight up false advertising. And I bet that Sony is trying to make sure that if CD Projekt Red ends up being sued, Sony wants to make sure they don't get sued as well. Sony Interactive Entertainment has confirmed it will give players of Cyberpunk 2077 on PS4 or on PS5 via backwards compatibility refunds for purchasing the game, but the platform holder is taking things a step further and actually removing Cyberpunk 2077 from PlayStation Store for digital purposes until further notice. This means, straight up, we may not actually see freaking Cyberpunk on PlayStation for the next couple months. They may actually delist it, making it unable to be purchased for the next couple months, maybe until after those massive updates that are coming in like January and February are released. This means, if you actually think about it, Cyberpunk is going to pretty much miss the entire Christmas holiday season because they're not going to be able to be purchased digitally. And I bet we're probably going to see a lot less than being sold in stores. In a newly posted refund-related page, Sony just confirmed its intentions to offer full refunds to all players who purchased Cyberpunk via the store, who are also committed to delisting the game. The company's full statement reads, Sony is striving to ensure a high level of customer satisfaction, therefore we will begin to offer a full refund to all gamers who have purchased Cyberpunk via the PlayStation Store. Sony will also be removing Cyberpunk from PlayStation Store until further notice. Once we have confirmed that you've purchased the Cyberpunk, we'll actually give you the refund and process it. Please note that the completion of the refund may also be based on your pay method. This is nuts. You know what I'm going to do right here? If you bought Cyberpunk, will you be requesting a refund? Yes. Answer. I'm actually surprised so many people said no. Sony's announcement came after messy messaging about Cyberpunk 2077's launch, which included significant portion gaps between PC and PS4. Now, what's funny is, if you look at their freaking apology, it's so silly to me to think about the fact that Sony, like, that Cyberpunk, they're just trying to shrug this off. Their stupid apology. Let's face facts. This apology straight up was not enough. Like, this is so insane. This whole Dear Gamer statement was flat out, this was insufficient. So it's kind of freaking impressive to me. I'm playing a bunch of Xbox tonight, just to be completely clear. I was actually playing Sea of Thieves with this girl I'm kind of hanging out with. And we're there sailing the seven seas. And I have to say that this is one of those moments that makes me really happy to be a PlayStation fan. Like, Xbox is killing it. Nintendo's killing it. But it's kind of nice that Sony has decided to step in and straight up do what Cyberpunk won't. Like, one of the craziest things about this is, I bet because they're still talking about these update patches, I bet they're going to remove this game for months. I bet we're not going to see freaking Cyberpunk return digitally to PlayStation for quite a freaking while. This is insane. And straight up, I actually think this is not only a good thing, it's setting a good precedent. I want to see this more often. The fact that a freaking studio is getting basically punished by the system, this is a good thing. Now, straight up, if you purchased it on PC, the game is still decent on PC. But today, actually, somebody messaged me on Instagram and they said, Dreamcast guy, I'm currently standing in a Walmart. There's a copy of freaking Cyberpunk in the store in front of me. Should I buy it? And I had to say no, because it's just not currently in a playable state. And it's totally bizarre to consider the fact that Sony themselves agrees. This is a very freaking good thing. And I feel like more than anything, something I just want to say real quick before we wrap this video up, this is a sign of the gamers having a freaking voice. This is us actually coming together and saying, this is not all right. PlayStation is listening to the fans who are straight up saying, we demand a refund. And Sony has just basically said, all right, we're stopping this problem now because nobody else will. What do you think of it? Isn't this the most bonkers freaking thing you've ever heard in your life? Seriously, I want to know your thoughts in the comments down below. I am just completely blown away about this. Maybe I'll make a longer video about it tomorrow. Please, yeah, give this video a like. Oh my god, I'm in shock. This is insane. I love you guys a bunch. Thanks to all the new subscribers. The channel's blowing up. This has been super good. And wow, F Cyberpunk. That was really loud. My roommate's going to get mad at me. Thanks so much for watching that video. If you want to see something else, you can always click this link to see what I put up last, or, you know, subscribe and see what's coming up next. Also, I promise that whatever I do, it'll try not to suck.